What's good, my beautiful people, and welcome to today's video. It's your boy Lee, and today we are at the Mecca of bodybuilding. We are at Gold's Gym here in Little Am, and we about to get in an intense back workout for y'all. So let's get it. I love that. Now today gonna be one of them days that I'm focused on going a lot heavier. For one reason being, it's been a while since I felt like I didn't got in a really, really great back and bicep workout. So today, my goal is to come in here and kill my back. And I mean, what better place to come in here and do it in than the house that Arnold built? As you see, the greatness behind me on the wall, so. I'm gonna come in here and get it in, bro. I'm gonna get my BCAA, go drop some water in here, and we about to get it cracking. That's the warm up. We always like to start with the rope, pull down to get the lats, engage, fire, nice control reps, working on that. Nine muscles. All right, next we got rows. Typically we do barbell row, but since we here, this is something that we don't have at LA Fitness, so I'm gonna try it out. I've seen reviews of it, not really a review, but I've seen people doing it online on YouTube, and I mean, they speak highly of it, so let's see what it's gonna do. Let's see. Oh yeah, that's too light. I love that because, for one thing, it's taking a lot of stress off of when you're doing bent over rows. Like, why you gotta focus on standing up and all that. It's with you being able to lay here, I can just solely focus on hitting the back, getting a good squeeze up top and pulling through. So, great machine. That's gonna be the last back compound movement, not the last back movement. We still got hyperextensions at the end, but we're about to go and tackle these biceps. So, on to the preacher curl. All right, first arm movement, not necessarily the preacher curl machine I wanted to use. I wanted to use the plated preacher curl, but when you're public gym, I use what you can use. But let's go ahead and get into it. Test out the weight. Most definitely can go up. All right, we was able to move to the machine that I wanted to originally do the preacher curls on. So as y'all can see, we're here. Here for a second to just get our bearings about ourselves, but I'll see y'all in the next clip. All right, guys, we are back at the crib, as you can tell. Had an amazing workout at the Mecca Gold's Gym, but I just wanted to come back here and talk about my experience there. The wife, she looking for a cup that she had a while back, a shaker cup, a teacup, whatever it's called, and she wanted it. She wanted desperately. But yeah, just wanted to go over my experience there at the Gold's Gym. Basically, we going to different gyms, just trying to try out some different gyms to see like what we might like. Because the thing is, LA Fitness is cool. Don't get me wrong, LA Fitness is cool. But for the most part, LA Fitness is a commercial gym. And I think it might be a little bit too commercial for me. Because I can't speak for nobody else, but whenever I do something, I like to take it serious. And I don't like to be one leg in, one leg out. So if I'm gonna jump into something, I'm gonna jump all the way in. And yes, like the hokey pokey, I guess, whatever. But when I decided to go down this road of fitness and getting my, you know, getting my health in order, I made a conscious decision to be all in. And if I'm gonna be all in, I wanna be surrounded around other people who taking this journey and taking this walk just as serious as I am. And that's not to say that the people that go to LA Fitness are bad people, because I'm not saying that at all, but I'm just saying at LA Fitness, the majority of people you gonna find in there, or at least the one by where we stay, the one that we go to, the majority of the people that you find in there, they're not trying to get into optimal bodybuilder shape. I would say that they just wanna go in there, get some cardio in, hang out, and go through the motions just to say like, hey, I worked out today. And that's cool. If that's all you want out of your fitness journey, that's cool. But that's not what I want for myself. So I'd rather be surrounded by like-minded people. I hope that you are the same way in your life. But even if you're not, hey, go join LA Fitness. It's cool people in there. Because, I mean, we done met some pretty cool people at LA Fitness. That's one thing I can say. But but when it comes to my experience at Gold Gym, first let's talk about the vibe. The vibe in there is amazing. The atmosphere, awesome. The music that they pumping out is awesome. I love being around. I love being in there and hearing the grunts, all the stuff that my wife think is funny and weird and crazy. But I love being around. It's some people call the meatheads. Give me a second, let me take a sip of protein shake. This is the protein shake I'm currently using right here. But I love being around fellow meatheads. That's good too, y'all. But the machine. Going in initially, the machines can be kind of intimidating because the machines they have in there, they're not gonna be like machines you've seen before at other gyms. They're like Gym 80 or Gym 80 and Pure Craft, which I guess is basically the same thing. But yeah, that Gym 80 and Pure Craft machines, they are German-made machines. So even if you are the most seasoned gym goer, you're gonna have to look at some type of video or at somebody who knows what they're doing to show you, hey bro, how you work this? And that's cool, because once you figure out how to work it and you get into the swing of like using the machine, you will be like, bro, this is dope. The Power Row machine. One thing I love about the Power Row machine is I love the stability and the control that I had with it, because with me laying flat, and as well, my wife loved that about it too, because what was initially on our workout was bent over rows. Bent over barbell rows. And if you know fitness, you know with bent over barbell rows, you gotta have your stable foundation, you bend over, and as well, one thing you gotta be mindful of is your back. I feel like with the row machine we use today, one thing it took out of the equation was my lower, me having to worry about making sure I had control of my lower back. So to me, that took out that element of me having to worry about me hurting my lower back. And most definitely with me working out with my wife, with her not being in season, I love the fact how they had to, I didn't have to worry about her hurting her lower back. Another thing with that is the way it was, you could do an ISO. So if I just wanted to do, it had different hand, I don't know if y'all can tell, but it had like different hand placement. So if I even wanted to just use that for like in replacement for a dumbbell row, I could get on there and do ISO row with it. And I love that about it. Another thing I loved about it, with it being secure and stable, it gave me a little boost or extra merit of confidence to pack on more weight, where if it was just a regular barbell row, I probably wouldn't have done as much weight on it as I did today. But with it being stable, secure, and me being able to just place my chest flat on it and just pull through my elbows, it gave me the confidence to add more weight to it. So I love that about it. And the last thing about that one I loved is, I love how it took the thinking out of my form. Meaning, because it's stationary, I could get on there and solely focus on, pulling through my elbows and putting the mental emphasis on making sure I was hitting those lats. I was hitting that inner back, make sure I was feeling the squeeze as I pulled up. And the thing with that is, I love it because for the first time in probably over a month after a back workout, I really feel like I went and worked out my back today. And on top of that, even my wife said the same thing. She said, using that machine and the machines we use today, after today's back workout, we actually left the gym feeling like, bro, we got a really good back exercise in. So I like that about it. Secondly, their ISO row machine. Now they have a ISO row machine at LA Fitness, but it's a lot more, far as hand placement, it's a lot more restricting. You probably couldn't tell right up on it. If you could, maybe you couldn't, but you have more mobility in the way the handles, how can I put this? The way that the handles were made, they were kind of on like some type of ball bearing system or something like that, to where you could move them and you didn't feel like your wrists were so restricted. So you could turn them this way, roll like this, keep them turned like this and roll like that. And as you pull, you could feel like the kind of give in your wrist. Now, with that being said, you still had to have some type of control of it, so you wouldn't have to be like, flopping like a bird that fell out the nest or something. But I think the fact that those hand placement things could move a little bit, I think that was dope, and it gave me a little relief personally, I feel, in my wrist, because I mean I strap it up for protection anyway, so I'm using straps. So I think that was dope. I love that about that ISO row machine. Another thing is I love how it had the foot assist on there, meaning, and when I say foot assist, I mean they had the little, it was a foot placement on there where when you push your foot down on the foot assist or the bar, it will pull the rose towards you, so you wouldn't have to get up and reach all forward just to pull it back. You just push down your foot, they come forward, you just grab them. And so I think that was dope. The one at LA Fitness don't have that. Now, I'm not saying, let me say this, I'm not poo-pooing on the one at LA Fitness. I'm not. Because I also think the one at LA Fitness is dope. But just because it's dope, that don't mean other little small details can't make something better. Anything could possibly be better. To be honest, the power row machine, in my humble opinion, don't get me wrong, I love the machine, but I wish that had some type of foot assist or something on it to where it would pull the weights up to you so you wouldn't have to reach and feel uncomfortable trying to reach and pull those back to you. So that's why I say every machine probably have a little tweak here or there that would make it better. So I think that was dope. Another thing about that gym to me brought back childhood memories. Because when I was younger, my dad owned a gym. And from what I can remember as a kid, I felt like my dad had a real fitness gym, like a real bodybuilder's gym. Because like I felt like a lot of the people in there were serious about coming in there and getting a real workout, getting a real pump. So that gym in particular gave me like a sense of nostalgia from when I was a kid. So I thought that was pretty dope as well. But overall, all in all, I really just think it's a dope gym. I mean, the fact that it's a iconic gym, yeah, it might not look like the Gold's Gym that's in Venice or in other places that are bigger, because it's not a huge gym. But even with it being a smaller, intimate, more Gold's Gym, I feel like they have more than what you need in there to go in there to achieve whatever your fitness goals is. So that is most definitely a gym you will see me going back to. And like I said, it's some other gyms in the area we want to check out, but I can't see. You can go online and look and see, you know, what other gyms have. I can't see other gyms fitting the mold of that gym, because a lot of the other gyms, if you just look on videos online and look at the pictures online, they look very commercial, like LA Fitness. And commercial isn't something that I'm looking for right now when it comes to a gym. So you most definitely will see us there a lot more. I will be honest and say that. But with that being said, if y'all enjoyed the content today, I want to encourage you to like, comment, subscribe, and share this video wherever you share cool things. Share this with somebody who's looking for a gym. Share this with somebody who needs motivation to go work out, because that's what I'm here for, baby. I'm here for the motivation, baby. You feel me? Go share this. Subscribe. Like and comment. If you think the machines I use were poo, say that, Lee, I think that machine sucks. And that's all good. I'm not going to be mad at you. That's your opinion. Everybody's entitled to their opinion. So let me know something. But if this is your first time joining us on the channel, please go back and check out the Road to 205 playlist and join the movement. My goal is to get down to 205. I am currently 289. I started my fitness journey on February the 2nd. So my goal is not to get to 205 by February the 2nd next year, but my goal is to get there. But I want to get there as healthy as possible. And I don't want to rush the process, because I'm trying to have as little or no extra skin hanging. And I know if I do it too quickly, I will have that extra skin hanging. So I'm trying to do it and avoid that. I'm trying to do it the slow and steady way. And that way I can make this a lifelong decision, and it's not just a fad for me. And as well, y'all know what time it is. It's time for the word of the day. So the word of the day is not coming from my book today, but the word of the day is coming straight from the Bible, because I feel led in my heart, led by the Spirit to share this word with you today. And this is for somebody. I know it's for somebody, and it's for you. please put it in the comment section and let me know, like, hey, that was for me. And that way I know that I did my due diligence and I did my duty as a follower, and I reached out and I spoke to your heart. The word of the day comes from Philippians 4:13, and it says, I can do all things through Christ which strengthens me. I'm gonna read it again. You can do all things through Christ who strengthens you. With that being said, if there's somebody within the sound of my voice and you've been watching me, you watch me for fitness or whatever it might be, you just watch me because I'm entertaining, but it's something that you know you want to get into and fear is stopping you, or you feel like you might not be able to do it, you might not be able to learn whatever it is you need to learn to achieve whatever it is, I'm here to tell you, bro, you can do it. Or sister, you can do it. Don't be afraid, because you, like the scripture said, you can do all things through Christ who strengthens you. God didn't give you the spirit of fear. He did not. But he gave you, the spirit of power, love, and a sound mind. So lean into that. And whatever it is, move in faith. Say your prayers and move with the grace God gave you to achieve whatever it is that fear, false evidence appearing real, is holding you back from right now at this very moment. Dig deep, trust in God, and go attack whatever it is. Because if it's on your heart to do it, it's a reason it's on your heart to do it. And if it's on your heart to do it, God gonna give you the grace to get it done. So with that being said, we're gonna end the video right there. And if you've been here before, you know how we end it, and you need to say it with me. Per usual, God love you. I love you. And remember, life is better when you're you. Y'all be blessed.